Hello and good evening. My name is Dr. Sama Akhtar. PCHF is honored to welcome Dr. Leila Akbar Larak as our expert speaker today. Dr. Larak will be talking about patient-reported outcome measures in congenital heart disease. Does it matter? Dr. Leila Akbar Larak is an assistant professor at the Aga Khan University School of Nursing and Midwifery and holds a joint appointment at the Department of Pediatrics and Child Health. She is also an honorary faculty member at the University of Sydney, Australia. Dr. Larak's PhD thesis and overall research focuses on long-term outcomes, morbidity, and health-related quality of life in patients with chronic diseases, focused particularly on congenital heart diseases. She has also been part of the steering committee at the International Consortium of Health Outcome Measures, ICHOM, in developing the standard sets for health outcome assessment in congenital heart disease. She is also a leading global health advocate at the International Society of Adult Congenital Heart Disease. Dr. Larak has various scholarly works and publications to her profile. Welcome, Dr. Leila.
Thank you so much. Am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Okay. So thank you so much, Dr. Sama, for such a nice introduction. I'm really humbled, and I'm really grateful to Pakistan Children Heart Foundation for this great initiative of creating awareness about congenital heart disease at community level, including both the healthcare providers, patients, and the parents. So I'm really thankful for that, and especially providing me this platform to present and talk on the topic which is very near and dear to my heart, but still, it is an area which is neglected. So in the next 20 or 25 minutes or so, I'm going to talk about the patient-reported outcomes, particularly in congenital heart disease, health-related quality of life in CHD patient population. And I'm also going to discuss these aspects, these domains, in the light of the literature, in the light of the published studies and research studies, not from high-income countries, but more so from Pakistan. Okay, so when we talk about congenital heart disease, the first thing that comes to our mind is an infant born with a heart disease. So it's something that that is not acquired, but the infant is born with that particular disease, which is the congenital, it's genetic. And as you can see it in this figure, that there's an infant, then there's a toddler, adolescent, teenager, and then there's young adults and adults. So with the advancement in diagnostics and clinical management in congenital heart disease, the survival in this patient population has increased. And so much so that about two-thirds of the patient population across the globe, they are adults. So that means that the needs of these individuals at different age cohorts. So for example, the needs of infant compared to toddler, compared to teenager, compared to adults and maybe and elderly would be very different. So as healthcare providers, what is important to understand is how we are able to address the needs of these patient population at different age cohort. And because this is a chronic and lifelong disease, so understanding this concept is very important. So when we talk about congenital heart disease, so the management may include some interventional cardiology, or it could be surgery. Regardless of whatever the clinical management these individual patients receive, they still have some, the complexity of CHD, of course, matters a lot. But generally speaking, these individuals, these patient population, they face or suffer through maybe different heart problems even after surgery. So for example, having arrhythmias or rhythm issues with the heart, or some of these individuals, they have some cognitive issues, some neurological issues, or maybe some of these individuals, they also have some heart failure problems. So a lot of factors, as I mentioned, that complexity, and then especially in this part of the world, low middle income countries like Pakistan, the patients present to healthcare providers, to the healthcare facilities at a later age. So the presentation is at a later age, and then of course the required treatment, they are also offered at a different age, at a later age compared to what is offered or what is available in high income countries. As we understand that about 70% of our population in Pakistan, they reside in rural areas where the availability, accessibility, and affordability, and of course, quality is an issue. So that is why, first of all, awareness is not there. And I'm really thankful to Pakistan Children Heart Foundation for creating, taking initiatives to create awareness about these diseases. So awareness is an issue, education is an issue, literacy is an issue, and of course, the availability of these healthcare facilities is an issue. And therefore, the health-related quality of life is very important in these individuals, and lifelong care is what is needed. So what is patient-reported outcome measures, which we call it simply, or the acronym is PROMS, PROMS and PRAMS, patient-reported outcome measures and patient-reported experiences measures. So it is what is important to patient. So for example, for a healthcare provider, things may be very different. So I, as a healthcare provider, to me, what is important is, for example, if a patient is coming after surgery and the echo is findings are normal, that's perfectly fine with me. That, okay, the numbers tell you something. But what is important to understand is what is important to patient and how patient perceives his or her health and his or her quality of life. So the numbers may be very different. For example, lab investigations may tell you something very different. But for a patient, if he or she is not able to perform activities of daily living or contribute in the society, be a normal, a contributing member of the society, that is more important to the patient and to the parents, which may not be a priority, for example, for a clinician, for a surgeon, because surgery is conducted, the surgeon does a surgery. Cardiologists, they do the follow-up of these patients, but for them, vital signs may matter a lot, but for a patient, what is important? What is the health-related quality of life? So what is the daily functioning which is important and as a priority for the patient? What is important to the patient in terms of his or her well-being, the physical health, psychological health, mental health, social health, and the personal beliefs? So PROMS and health-related quality of life, basically health-related quality of life comes under PROMS, the patient-reported outcome measure, that what is important and how does the patient define health measures, health outcomes. So when we talk about the physical, emotional, functional status of these individuals, so it does tell you the story. It does tell you that whatever the intervention, whatever the clinical management that has been given to the patient, of course it tells the patient's health status, but in the opinion of patient and not what healthcare providers perceive. And there are a lot of literature studies conducted where there has been discrepancies. There have been discrepancies in terms of what the healthcare providers prioritized for patients versus what the patient they themselves felt that this is important for them. So American Heart Association, and there are so many other organizations which focuses that the importance and the significance of health-related quality of life or patient-reported outcome measures in a lot of different chronic diseases, but I'll be focusing more on CHD. So why this is so important? Because it not only tells what is important to patient, it doesn't only tell you the current health status of the patient, but it also identifies the hidden problems. So for example, if a patient comes to a healthcare provider and the healthcare provider assesses patient's health-related quality of life, asks the patient what is important, what are the issues and challenges that the patient is going through. So for example, if there is something, the patient has shortness of breath, so that tells you that something is not right with the heart. So, or maybe there is some other organ that is getting affected. So that tells the healthcare provider, and then what resources would be required for this health, for this patient population, and what interventions which needs to be planned. So it provides, it gives you a room for doing some prophylactic measures in order to prevent the patient from going into complications or maybe mitigating the current health issues and challenges which the patient is going through. So here, as you see that in the current practice, majority of the healthcare providers, though we all understand that PROMS and health-related quality of life assessment is so important, but still the focus in the current healthcare system is more on the drugs, on the clinical management, on the diagnostics, and what is important to patient's preferences, what are some of the sociocultural aspects that affects patients' health outcomes is still missing. So when we talk about CHD distribution globally, Unfortunately, the regions, the areas in the across the globe where the resources are scarce are the regions or the areas where the prevalence of or the incidence of CHD, congenital heart disease, is highest. So in other words, the resources are less and the disease burden is more. And you, as I have highlighted, that this is more of Southeast Asian countries, where Pakistan and so many other low middle income countries fall into these regions. So when we talk about Pakistan, as we know that our population is about 220 million, though we do not have a data surveillance or a database, a registry to claim that these are the number of CHD patients who are born annually. But this is an international prevalence or the incidence data that about 8 to 10 per 1,000 live births. So CHD patient population is like 8 to 10 per 1,000 live births. So for every 1,000 live births, about 8 to 10 children who are born, they have CHD. And this is global data. So when we infer it to our population, about 50 to 60,000 children are born with CHD every year in Pakistan. But unfortunately, to address the needs of this patient population with CHD, we have only 6 hospitals. This is an approximation, and I look forward to that the contribution with which PCHF is doing, and inshallah, I look forward to that there may be more such organizations, and I foresee the number of these hospitals and the number of surgeries to be increased in the upcoming years. But unfortunately, as of now, about 3,000 or 3,000 plus surgeries are conducted. These are the only fortunate ones. And we have a handful of pediatric cardiac surgeon and cardiologist. So the question is, we are struggling with the resources and the disease burden is huge. And as I mentioned, that the literacy is low, about 60% is the literacy rate in Pakistan. And by literacy, we define literacy as a person, when a person can write his or her name or maybe do a signature. This is how we define literacy. And we are not discussing or talking about health literacy. Health literacy comes later, that how much understanding our population has about the health. So we are just talking about literacy, which is 60%, about 70% to 2/3 of our population, they reside in rural areas where the affordability, availability, accessibility, and quality is an issue. So that becomes very important to understand. And I remember that when I started this discussion about patient reported outcome measures with my colleagues, with other healthcare providers, the first counter argument was, should we be focusing more on survival? Because this is the issue. We have very limited hospitals. We have a handful of cardiologists and cardiac surgeons. So who cares? What does patient feel? And secondly, when we are talking that we do not have a lot, huge educated patient population. So for them and a lot of people, they cannot afford to. So does it really matter that what does the patient think? Because saving a child is more important compared to what he or she or his or her parents feel about. And therefore, I looked into literature, and from this slide onwards, I'm going to share my PhD journey, because my PhD dissertation, it focused on assessing health-related quality of life and patient-reported outcome measures in congenital heart disease surgical patients in Pakistan. So the findings were very interesting. So as you can see that this study was conducted and data was collected from children, adolescent, teenagers, adults, young adults, and elderly as well. And patients' data was compared with their age-matched siblings, healthy siblings. So you can see that under quality of life, as I mentioned earlier, that there are different domains. So physical domain, emotional, social, school, or the work-related, activity-related, psychosocial, cognitive, and an overall quality of life. So you can see in that the health-related quality of life of patients, regardless of the age, it was statistically significantly lower compared to their age-matched healthy siblings in all the domains. To gain further understanding of what does that mean? So what does that mean if the emotional functioning is lower compared to you know, healthy siblings, or maybe physical functioning or psychosocial functioning was lower? So I also did some in-depth qualitative interviews of these individuals and their parents. So they showed different concerns. So for example, they were concerned about their health because a lot of these individuals, despite they had gone through surgical procedure for whatever the seizure diagnosis they had, they had symptoms. So a lot of these individuals, they were having breathing problems, they were having on and off infection, and there were so many other health issues that they were going through. Some of them were going through mental health issues, psychological issues. Education was an issue because these individuals, especially the kids, when they went through surgery and they had hospitalizations, of course, they missed their school days. The concern was about the job, the career, financial concerns, because as we all understand and appreciate that here in Pakistan, unfortunately, people have to pay from the pocket. And CHD surgery and its management, it's quite expensive. That was again concerned because we do not have universal health coverage. Reoperation was a concern because some of these seizure diagnoses, they were told that they would have to go for reoperation. Marriage, conception, all these were the concerns raised and highlighted by parents, patients, and the individuals. So I'm going to share some of the quotes that these patients, they shared. So for example, as I mentioned that we do not have universal health coverage, and especially females in our culture, still very few females are the ones who are independent financially, and majority are still dependent on the male members of their family, be it husband, father, brother. So the concern was that at that time, somebody was supporting financially. So what is going to happen once that person, the male member of that family dies? And normality was also a concern because parents felt that the child with CHD was not able to play like other kids. Or maybe, you know, even one parent I could still recall, the mother shared that she felt that her child has actually lost the childhood because that child had multiple surgeries. Adult individuals, especially females, they were concerned about their marriage because still in our culture, their arranged marriage is still prevalent. So when the marriage proposals were sent, so the concern was whether the female would be able to conceive and whether the female is medically fit. That was more important. Interestingly, similar sort of like regarding the marriage, this was also a concern for parents, even when the CHD child or the patient was, quite young, was a child. And this was something very interesting finding because in high-income countries, this was not highlighted in the literature. And of course, surgical scar was the concern because in our culture, cosmetic issue, cosmetic like concerns are more important compared to what if, the health is affected, people are okay with that. But they're more concerned about, especially for the females, that, the female should be good looking and there shouldn't be any scar, especially the surgical scar. Because some of these patients, they shared that they had to wear high neck shirts to hide the scar. Additionally, since it's a patriarchal society, Pakistan and a lot of other low middle income countries, it's male dominant society. So some of the family members and the neighbors, they were concerned, and the parents shared that spending money on CHD surgery for a female child was a concern. This was the perception of our society, and and some of the parents, they literally cried that it was very difficult for them to convince the family the society that spending in it's like the child who has to be saved, and it doesn't matter that what is the gender, but this is what the society's perception was. And interestingly, there were few adults, female patients, who shared that they wanted to have a female counselor. And they specifically requested not to record their interviews, but the request was that if they should, because this is a socio-cultural aspect, they were not comfortable with the male cardiologist or male counselors. Similarly, participants, they also shared that they were more concerned about being able to fulfill the responsibilities and the expectations of their family, of the society, being a female. So the concern was she's able to do house chores. And for males, it was the concern was that they were son and elder brother. So the concern was they are able to financially support the family. And of course, employment was an issue. because the job, the organizations, different organizations, they were not comfortable hiring people with congenital heart disease, and there were a lot of reservations, and they had to go through multiple diagnostic tests and investigations, and employment was highlighted by a lot of participants. Again, merit was an issue. Okay, so in terms of the societal perceptions, some participants, they shared that people feel or people perceive it, society perceives it, that CHD is because of somebody's sins. Guna hai, kisi ne koi guna kiya hai, iski wajah se usko CHD, congenital heart disease, ba. And iske alawa, people also felt, shared ke CHD was considered and perceived as a contagious disease. Contagious ka matlab ye hai ki jis jo ek se dusre ko lage, jaise COVID ki hum jab baat karte hain. So COVID ke liye humne, we learned ke what are some of the SOPs that have to be followed, and there were reasons for that, because COVID is such a, is an infectious disease, whereas congenital heart disease is a non-communicable disease. It's not infectious disease, but this is what the perception was, and therefore it is very important that we as a group, as healthcare providers, you know, collectively, how can we create awareness about CHD? This is very important, because until the awareness is not there, people do not, and the society doesn't have the understanding about what CHD is and what a patient with CHD undergoes through, this change will never come. Normality was again an issue, and people were not comfortable taking medications in front of their other family members and so on. We also did a study on adult congenital heart disease. A common understanding is like patients do not come for follow-up, because a lot of these individuals, when they undergo surgery or any intervention for CHD, majority of these individuals, they are not regular in follow-up. And the perception, like we, when we were conducting this study, so we thought that the reasons would be, and a lot of these health, because we collected data from patients, and we also collected data from healthcare providers from public and private hospitals. So the healthcare providers, they felt that patients are not regular in their follow-ups, they are not compliant, because of the cost, or because of, you know, traveling, or they are living in far-flung areas, whereas the patients or the participants, they shared that they were not told about it. So there was a discrepancy in, maybe there was some comprehension issue, or maybe, you know, they were never told about it. So that was very interesting, and this really tells us something. That even if the healthcare provider, if the surgeon or the cardiologist has discussed with the patient about lifelong care, how much that patient has understood, how much those parents have understood, because we need to be mindful that, of course, literacy and health literacy is an issue in our country and in our patient population. So what is the responsibility of us as healthcare providers? IChom is the International Consortium of Health Outcome Measures. So this organization develops standard sets for different chronic diseases. And Farhan Ahmed from Pakistan Children Heart Foundation, Dr. Babar Hassan, and myself. So we three were part of the steering committee to develop standard sets for congenital heart disease. And this was very interesting, because for CHD, we had a strong voice from LMIC, from low middle income country, from Pakistan. So what, because a lot of times in the past, when such type of standard sets were developed, the experts from high income countries, where the socio demographics, where the healthcare system, where the needs and the socio cultural factors are very different from what we have here in Pakistan. So this was very an interesting and a very rigorous exercise. Secondly, before finalizing these CHD standard sets, we also validated these sets in our patient population. So we did pilot testing, and based on the pilot testing results, there were some modifications. So for example, financial needs and financial implications because of the CHD surgery was not actually a need or a priority for high-income countries. But this was something highlighted by our patient population, by the parents of children with CHD, and this was then added into the final standard sets of congenital heart disease. And we will hopefully be doing the validity and the feasibility study for these standard sets in Pakistan. This is another study, Approach IS2, where we are, and this study is conducted in 40 plus countries and about 80 plus sites. It's about 16,000 plus data across the globe of congenital heart disease, adults congenital heart disease, ACHD. And this would also bring a lot of knowledge and a lot of findings from different parts of the world. And we'll be able to compare that, how are things, how is the patient reported outcomes, how is the quality of life different across different countries, across the globe, or maybe it's the same. So the findings from this study, that we are still in the data collection phase. So the findings from the study would be very interesting. If we see what is next. So if we see this population pyramid of Pakistan, so 2016 versus 2015. So 3 decades from now, or even more than 3 decades. So you can see there's a substantial increase. This is a projection. This is a projected population pyramid based on our birth rate of the country, Pakistan. So you can see there's substantial increase in the population of the country in next 30 years or so. When we talk about congenital heart disease, it is dependent on the live births, as I mentioned earlier. So if the population is going to increase, that means the incidence and the prevalence of congenital heart disease. So there will be more children born with congenital heart disease. And we are this is 2021, right? So at present, we are discussing that what is important to patient reported outcome measures and the quality of life, and what are some of the needs and issues and challenges of this patient population. So 30 years down the road, because we are into globally, as I mentioned, that we have about 2/3 of the patient population of CHD who are adults. And as we move on, because of further advancement in clinical management based on research and evidence, we foresee that the age might increase. And in addition to age, because of this substantially increased population pyramid, we foresee that the numbers of CHD would also increase. So the question is, what should be our strategy down the road? Because if we start strategizing what we foresee in the next 30 years or so, so what healthcare facilities would be required? In addition to healthcare facilities, what system should be there? What infrastructure is required? What expertise are required? What are some of the things that we should foresee and we should plan from now? So the way forward is health-related quality of life, patient-reported outcome measure, that should be part of regular clinical assessment. And we should be identifying high-risk patients whatever the requirements are for their long-term follow-ups, short-term follow-ups. Patient-centered care approach, as I mentioned, that it is very important that patients should be part of the shared decision-making. So the physician is there, the patient is there, and the healthcare provider should discuss in detail about what are some of the consequences that could happen because of CHD. It's a lifelong, it's a chronic or a lifelong disease. And even after surgery, what are some of the issues and challenges that should be anticipated? And this should be based on research and literature. And then based on that information and the health literacy, or this is empowering the patients and their families. So based on that, what does the patient feel or the family feels it's important for them? Educating them and structured healthcare programs, which should be gender specific, which should be contextual. And then of course, capacity building through collaborations and developing consortiums between low middle income countries and high income countries in academia, clinical component and research. So this is a collage of some of the drawings and the paintings and colorings, which my study participants, when I was doing the data collection, so they did it. And this is reminds me of all those children, their parents who participated and who shared their experiences when they underwent CHD surgery, and they shared their issues and challenges, and that was very interesting. And these are the glimpses of some scholarly work from Pakistan, because I mentioned that a lot of data is available from high income countries, but unfortunately there wasn't any data, not from the low middle income countries only, but nothing was there from Pakistan, or hardly very few studies were there. As an advocate, I'm part of the ISEC, which is International Society for Adult Congenital Heart Disease, and I'm chairing the Global Health Working Group. and I'm trying to bring, whatever whatever we could contribute for the CHD patient population across the globe, and with particular focus on LMIC and the regions where the resources are scarce. So thank you so much, and I'm here to address and respond to any questions.
Thank you very much, Dr. Larak. It was a very elaborate and informative presentation, particularly bahut sare jo is waqt pertinent problems hain in Pakistan. You have highlighted that particularly, I think, which should be emphasized more in the healthcare system in Pakistan, is giving a voice to the patient. Because we at Pakistan Children's Heart Foundation, we ourselves have come across many patients. Not everyone has the courage to actually ask their health practitioner these questions. But on the one-off occasion, so it is very unfortunate. This is a chronic disease. This is a lifelong disease. So they actually consider not giving, getting their child the initial treatment. Ke isne to ab sari zindagi bimari rehna hai, to koi fayda nahi hai. So just, Allah Taala pe chhod dete, like you mentioned, ke matlab aapne kuch stigmas highlight kiye the ke guna hoga or something like that. So I think education and awareness is definitely very important. So moving on to the questions and answers, sabse pehle ye hai ke, you have mentioned that now the importance of patient reported outcomes are very significant. So kis had tak ki Pakistan mein implement ho chuka hai, ya matlab iski progress ab tak kya hai?
Pakistan ki jahan tak aap baat karti hai, Pakistan mein to iska buy-in is still, I'm struggling for that. So they are very research mein to phir bhi thoda bahut people have started thinking it from that perspective, but I am trying my best and trying to advocate people ke bhai this should be part of clinical practice. Research mein still like AKU ki main agar main Aga Khan ki baat karun, so hum bahut sari cheezon mein isko jo hai integrate kar rahe hain ke what is patient reported outcome measures and all those things, quality of life kya hai in different chronic diseases. So a lot of different projects are there which are in progress and process. But clinical practice ki jahan tak hum baat karte hain, wo still jo hai wo huge gap hai. So I think it's a long way to go. Important thing is ke hum kitna logon ko awareness de, especially healthcare providers ko, because jab tak hum is cheez ko nahi understand karenge, jab tak hum usko implement nahi karenge. Patients ko to jo hai they rely on healthcare providers, aur hamare yahan to jo hai wo doctors ko khuda mante hain ye log ki theek hai usne hamare bacche ki jaan bachayi hai, right? और अक्सर औकात जो है वो जब वो फाइनेंशियल अफोर्डेबिलिटी की बात आती है तो उसके अंदर जो है ना एक पावर रिलेशनशिप ना चाहते हुए भी डेवलप हो जाता है कि अगर वो पेशेंट जो है उसको हॉस्पिटल को फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस देती है या कोई ऑर्गेनाइजेशन उसको फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस देती है या देता है, तो पेरेंट्स ये फील करते हैं या पेशेंट्स ये फील करते हैं कि दे आर ऑब्लाइज्ड. सो उस सिनेरियो के अंदर एक वो पेशेंट उस फैमिली से बिलोंग करने वाला जो कि बिलो पावर्टी लाइन है, जो इतना लिटरेट नहीं है, इतना एम्पावर्ड नहीं है, उसके पास उसको पता ही नहीं कि उसके राइट्स क्या है, उस सिनेरियो के अंदर हमारी ज्यादा रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी बढ़ जाती है एज हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर्स कि हम उसका ज्यादा सोचें कि किस तरीके से हम उसको एम्पावर करें और किस तरीके से हम उसको उसको इंफॉर्मेशन दें, उसको नॉलेज दें, उसको एजुकेट करें उसके राइट्स के बारे में और उस पर्टिकुलर जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर सी एच डी की हम बात करें तो वो सर्जिकल प्रोसीजर या जो भी इंटरवेंशन की तरफ जा रहे हैं तो उसको इन्फॉर्म करना प्रॉपर और फिर उसको उस तरीके से गाइड करना वो बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है. और आई थिंक जो आर्ग्यूमेंट जैसे मैंने कहा कि डज इट मैटर, इट डज मैटर एंड इट रियली मैटर्स. और इस सिनेरियो के अंदर जबकि हमारे पास पेशेंट पॉपुलेशन बहुत डिफरेंट बैकग्राउंड की है, द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी आई थिंक इट डबल्स ऑन द हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर्स. लेकिन अनफॉर्चुनेटली अभी तक उस तरीके से नहीं है कंट्री वाइड, एंड आई थिंक वी ऑल नीड टू एडवोकेट कलेक्टिवली फॉर दिस थिंग. पेशेंट वॉइस कितनी इम्पोर्टेंट है.
जी डेफिनेटली. तो कमिंग फ्रॉम योर एक्सपीरियंस, यू कंडक्टेड योर थीसिस इन ऑस्ट्रेलिया, तो इन हाई इनकम कंट्रीज भी ऐसी ही सिचुएशन है?
हाई इनकम कंट्रीज के अंदर जैसे कि क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ इज डेफिनेटली लोअर इन सीएचडी पेशेंट पॉपुलेशन कंपेयर टू कंट्रोल ग्रुप का मतलब ये कि जो भी हेल्दी है, मगर इस पे जब मैंने ये कंपेयर किया कि हाई इनकम कंट्रीज के सीएचडी पेशेंट पॉपुलेशन वर्सेस लो मिडिल इनकम कंट्री जैसे हमारे पाकिस्तान की है, तो उसमें भी कंपैरेटिवली हमारी पेशेंट पॉपुलेशन की क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ वाज मच लोअर देन हाई इनकम कंट्रीज. हालांकि कंजेनिटल हार्ट डिजीज दोनों सेम है, मगर क्योंकि वहाँ पे बहुत एजुकेशन बड़ा डिफरेंट है, वहाँ पे हेल्थ केयर सिस्टम बड़ा डिफरेंट है, डायग्नोसिस बहुत अर्ली हो जाता है बिकॉज के वहाँ पे तो जो है वो प्रेगनेंसी के दौरान भी अल्ट्रासाउंड हो जाता है, उसमें आइडेंटिफाई अक्सर ही हो जाता है कि अगर किसी को है कंजेनिटल तो उस टाइम पे ही कि अर्ली कितना अर्ली उसको ऑपरेट करना है. लेकिन हमारे यहाँ तो अनफॉर्चुनेटली उस तरीके से वो फैसिलिटीज नहीं है. बहुत सारे लोग अभी भी रूरल एरियाज में, देहातों में, गाँव में रहते हैं, वहाँ पे अंडरस्टैंडिंग नहीं, कितने बच्चे उसी तरीके से, वो बच्चा साइन ऑफ हो गया पता ही नहीं चला, वो कह रहे कि जी तो अल्लाह की देन थी, ये तो होना था, शायद बच्चा बचा ही नहीं, लेकिन हो सकता है उसमें से कितने हैं. क्योंकि हमारे पास प्रॉपर डेटाबेसेस उस तरीके से नहीं है, उस तरीके से इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर नहीं है, तो ऑफ कोर्स क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ वाज वेरी डिफरेंट देयर. और फिर उसके लिए सपोर्ट सिस्टम जो रिक्वायर्ड है, सो फॉर एग्जांपल अगर हम सिंपल यहाँ की एग्जांपल लें कि काउंसलर्स, तो काउंसलर के लिए ऑफ कोर्स देयर इज अ कॉस्ट अटैच्ड टू इट. वहाँ पे आपको पे फ्रॉम द पॉकेट नहीं होता, वहाँ पे गवर्नमेंट पे करती है आपको. सो यूनिवर्सल हेल्थ कवरेज है, सो यू नो वो बहुत सारी चीज़ें मैटर करती है. और अगर आप जैसे जॉब पे से आप ऑफ ले रहे हैं, तो फिर जो भी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है वो आपको सपोर्ट कर रही है, और स्पेशली किसी भी किस्म के आपको हेल्थ के इश्यूज है, तो देर आर यू नो एम्प्लॉयमेंट पॉसिबिलिटीज जो कि अनफॉर्चुनेटली हमारे पास उस तरीके से नहीं है. सो आई थिंक देर इज वेरिएबिलिटी, बट जनरली स्पीकिंग क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ वहाँ पे भी सी एच डी के साथ, बिकॉज देर आर सम फिजियोलॉजिकल, या जो हम कहेंगे कि जो अगर हार्ट का कोई प्रॉब्लम है तो वो है, वो पाकिस्तान के बच्चे में भी है, वो ऑस्ट्रेलिया या किसी हाई इनकम कंट्री के बच्चे के लिए भी है. लेकिन जैसे हम कहते हैं सोशल डिटर्मिनेंस ऑफ हेल्थ, के बहुत सारी चीज़ें मैटर करती है, आपकी एजुकेशन, आपकी इनकम, हेल्थ सिस्टम्स, आपका जो फैमिली स्ट्रक्चर है, या बहुत सारी दूसरी चीज़ें जो रिसोर्सेज, तो वो फिर बहुत उस पर इम्पैक्ट आता है क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ पे.
डेफिनेटली. अच्छा, तो फिर आपने ये मेंशन किया कि अवेयरनेस के हवाले से, तो फॉर आवर हेल्थ प्रोफेशनल्स हु आर वाचिंग दिस वेबिनार एंड पेशेंट्स, तो क्या एक्सपेक्टेशंस होनी चाहिए फ्रॉम अ हेल्थ प्रोफेशनल, फॉर एग्जांपल अगर वो देहात में जा रहे हैं टू फॉर यू नो फॉर डायग्नोसिस एंड रेफरल ऑफ चिल्ड्रन विद कंजेनिटल हार्ट डिजीज, के वो अगर हम इसको इनिशिएट करें एज एन इनिशिएटिव, अगर हम इसको लाइक यू नो फ्रॉम बेबी स्टेप्स इफ वी स्टार्ट, तो क्या एक्सपेक्टेशंस होनी चाहिए, किस तरह वो एजुकेट कर सकते हैं द रूरल पॉपुलेशन, और दूसरा पेशेंट्स के जैसे आपने राइट्स का मेंशन किया था, तो व्हाट मतलब बेसिक राइट्स, या हमारे पेशेंट्स को ये नॉलेज होना चाहिए कि हमने ये क्वेश्चंस पूछने हैं अपने हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर से, या ये हमारा राइट है.
थैंक यू फॉर, इट्स अ वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन. इम्पॉर्टेंट ये है कि हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर्स, जैसे हमने कहा कि अगर चाहे अर्बन सेटिंग में है, शहर में है, या रूरल सेटिंग में, देहातों गांव में, जिस तरह स्क्रीनिंग के लिए जा रहे हैं या वहाँ के पेशेंट्स आपके पास आ रहे हैं, इम्पॉर्टेंट ये है कि पेशेंट की कॉम्प्रिहेंशन बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. अक्सर औकात ये होता है कि एज हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर्स हमें लगता है कि हमने पेशेंट को या पेरेंट को या फैमिली को समझा तो दिया है, मगर वो अक्सर मेडिकल लैंग्वेज जो बड़े डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स होते हैं या इंग्लिश की वोकेबलरी यूज करते हैं, तो हमें ये बहुत समझना जरूरी है एज हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ये कि डेफिनेटली इंफॉर्मेशन देना बहुत जरूरी है, मगर इंफॉर्मेशन किस लेवल की होनी चाहिए, उस लेवल की हो कि वो सामने वाला पर्सन उसको समझ रहा है, उसको कॉम्प्रिहेंड कर रहा है. और आप उससे पेशेंट से पूछे, जब आप बात कर रहे हैं कि क्या सवाल आपके हैं, या ये कि उसको थोड़ा सा टाइम, एक ओपन, बिकॉज रेपो बिल्डिंग के अंदर भी थोड़ा सा टाइम लगता है, तो आप थोड़ा सा टाइम उस तरीके से दे के वो जो है वो आपसे सवाल कर सके. और आप जो लैंग्वेज यूज कर रहे हैं वो आप कितनी सिंपल लैंग्वेज हो कि वो पेशेंट या पेरेंट जो है, जो भी लैंग्वेज यूज करता है, वो समझ सके. अगर उर्दू भी यूज कर रहे हैं तो कभी कभार बहुत डिफिकल्ट वर्ड्स होते हैं उर्दू के, अगर आप ट्रांसलेट करते हो उसको, तो कॉमन लैंग्वेज के अंदर हो. जैसे हम अक्सर बोलते हैं रिसर्च के अंदर इन्फॉर्म कॉन्सेंट का जो लैंग्वेज, यानी कि आप जो इजाजतनामा लेते हैं किसी रिसर्च के लिए या कोई भी क्लिनिकल प्रोसीजर के लिए, वो इतना सिंपल होना चाहिए कि ग्रेड 3 या 4 का जो बच्चा है वो समझ सके. लैंग्वेज उसकी इतनी सिंपल होनी चाहिए. तो कहने को तो हमने इंग्लिश से ट्रांसलेट तो कर दिया है उर्दू में, जो कि हमारी कॉमनली स्पोकन लैंग्वेज है या हमारी कौमी जबान है, लेकिन वो फिर भी ट्रांसलेशन में इतना डिफिकल्ट हो गया कि कभी कभी इंग्लिश ज्यादा ईजी लगता है वो, अगर आप देखें तो. वो कॉम्प्रिहेंशन का एलिमेंट बहुत ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है. फिर ये कि हमें पेशेंट को इतना कम्फर्ट देना है, फैमिली को, कि भाई वो आपके साथ खुल के बात कर सके, जो सवालात तो उसके दिमाग में है उसको कर सके. उसके लिए जरूरी है कि हेल्थ के प्रोवाइडर प्रॉपर टाइम दे, प्रॉपर अटेंशन दे. लेकिन अनफॉर्चुनेटली देर आर मल्टीपल रीजन फॉर दैट के वो एक तो बाइन उस तरीके से अंडरस्टैंडिंग नहीं है, या ये कि उनको लगता है, या जनरली हॉस्पिटल में जो है एक पेपर दे दिया जाता है बहुत सारे हॉस्पिटल्स में कि पेशेंट्स के आपके राइट्स क्या है. जब एडमिशन होता है तो एक पेपर थमा दिया जाता है कि ये आपके राइट्स है. अब वो राइट्स आपने दे दिए, पेपर तो आपने अपना काम कर दिया, लेकिन वो पेशेंट या फैमिली ने कितना उसको समझा और उसको कितना कॉम्प्रीहेंड किया और उसको कितना ये समझ आया कि ये मेरे राइट्स है और मैं इसको एक्सरसाइज कैसे करूँ. तो आई थिंक ये पूरे सिस्टम की हम बात कर रहे हैं एंड इट्स नॉट जस्ट वन पर्सन कि मैं बैठ के समझा रही हूँ या मैं बैठ के नहीं समझा रही हूँ उस तरीके से. इट्स अ सपोर्ट विच द सिस्टम प्रोवाइड्स कि अगर वो पूछ रहा है लेकिन सिस्टम के अंदर ये है कि नहीं जी पेशेंट के साथ आपने इतने मिनट से ज्यादा नहीं देना बिकॉज बाहर बहुत लंबी लाइन लगी हुई है, तो हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर के लिए भी ये थोड़ा चैलेंजिंग हो जाता है. तो आई थिंक ये पूरे सिस्टम की हम बात कर रहे हैं कि सिस्टम इस तरीके से हो कि वो सपोर्ट करे इस किस्म की चीज़ों को, पेशेंट एम्पावरमेंट को, पेशेंट की हेल्थ लिटरेसी को सपोर्ट करे, और उस तरीके से फिर जो एक पूरा सिस्टम बने कि भाई वो हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर जो फिजिशियन है या वो नर्स है वो किस तरीके से किस लेवल पे जाके उससे बात कर रही है और उसको कितना समझ आ रहा है, वो सर्जन या कार्डियोलॉजिस्ट कितना एक्सेसिबल है उस पेशेंट के लिए या उसकी फैमिली के लिए. सो बहुत सारी चीज़ें कंसिडर करने की ज़रूरत है. एंड आई थिंक ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है कि जो सोशल डिटर्मिनेंट्स ऑफ हेल्थ की मैंने बात की कि ये सारी चीज़ें बड़ा मैटर करती है बिकॉज हर सिर्फ सर्जरी तो एक प्रोसीजर है या कोई कैथेटराइजेशन इंटरवेंशनल कैथेटराइजेशन वो एक प्रोसीजर है. उसके साथ जो पेशेंट आ रहा है वो बच्चा आ रहा है वो अपने साथ पूरी हिस्ट्री लेकर आ रहा है, उसकी फैमिली, उसका बैकग्राउंड, उसका सोशो कल्चरल फैक्टर, बहुत सारी चीज़ें उसमें मैटर करती है. जैसे कि जेंडर का मैंने इसमें बताया कि रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज और यू नो एक्सपेक्टेशन, सोसाइटी का मैंने बताया. तो किस तरीके से हम एंड वन स्टेप एट अ टाइम, तो किस तरीके से हम पेशेंट और फैमिली को जो है वो एम्पावर करें और साइमल्टेनियसली उनको अवेयरनेस दें, क्योंकि ये भी इम्पॉर्टेंट है ना कि अगर मैं एज अ पेरेंट मुझे ही अंडरस्टैंडिंग नहीं है तो मैं अपनी सोसाइटी को, अपनी फैमिली को या नेबर्स को किस तरीके से मैं जो है वो उनका परसेप्शन को चेंज करूंगी. तो फर्स्ट स्टेप आप पेशेंट एंड फैमिली के ऊपर बात करें और फिर साइमल्टेनियसली इस किस्म के वेबिनार्स या डिफरेंट प्लेटफॉर्म्स हैं जैसे कि मीडिया के थ्रू आप किस तरीके से सोसाइटी एंड कम्युनिटी को उस चीज़ की अवेयरनेस दें कि कंजेनिटल हार्ट डिजीज इज अ नॉन कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज, कंटेजियस नहीं है ये. इसके साथ जो बच्चे या जो पेशेंट्स होते हैं दे कैन लीड परफेक्टली नॉर्मल लाइफ और जो उनके इशूज एंड चैलेंजेस एंड वी आर देयर टू सपोर्ट. इसमें जैसे कि पेरेंट सपोर्ट ग्रुप हम बिल्कुल इसमें होना चाहिए कि किस तरीके से जैसे वो अगर पेरेंट को अगर उसका बच्चा जा रहा है सर्जरी के लिए तो जो दूसरे पेरेंट्स जिनके बच्चे जा चुके हैं, जिनकी सर्जरी हो चुकी है, आफ्टर सर्जरी के क्या वो अपने एक्सपीरियंसेस शेयर करें और डाउन द रोड ये सब एक दूसरे के साथ जो है एज अ सपोर्ट ग्रुप एक दूसरे के साथ अपने एक्सपीरियंसेस, अपने कंसर्न शेयर करें. और यू नो मे बी PCHF कुड टेक दिस एज एन इनिशिएटिव एंड वी आर ऑल देयर टू सपोर्ट यू कि आपके पास ऑलरेडी पेशेंट पूल काफ़ी है. So we can initiate this, parent support group, or there could be so many other strategies.
Definitely, that is a wonderful food for thought. And I think the main key is jo sare CHT professionals are coming together and addressing these challenges together can really help progress CHT healthcare in Pakistan. So before we conclude, ek jo hamara usually question aata hai, hamare ek webinar hua tha with Amy Verstappen and with Dr. Ali Zaidi as well, jo hamara transition of care from children to adult congenital heart disease, particularly just aapne female patients ka jo hai wo issue highlight kiya, jo stigmas that are related to the physical appearance. So could you please give a message to the parents of females, just for example jab unki they get married and then their husbands or their families, they should be educated ki this this person is capable of living a normal healthy life provided ki jis tarah a good quality of life. So unke liye agar please aap ek message de dein.
बिल्कुल. सो कंजेनिटल हार्ट डिजीज़ जो जिस तरह मैंने कहा एक नॉन कम्युनिकेबल डिजीज़ है, किसी से एक दूसरे को नहीं लगती है. ठीक है, अगर उसकी जो भी सर्जरी, ये ऑफ कोर्स द फैक्ट इज़ कि ये लाइफ लॉन्ग डिजीज़ है, क्रॉनिक डिजीज़ है. ठीक है, अगर बचपन में भी सर्जरी हुई है तो उसके कभी कभार जो है वो कुछ इसके इम्पैक्ट रहता है थ्रू आउट द लाइफ. ठीक है, मगर इम्पॉर्टेंट ये है कि ये इंडिविजुअल्स जो है वो बिल्कुल शादी कर सकते हैं. कंसेप्शन वगैरह के हवाले से जो है वो बिल्कुल उनको किसी से कंसल्ट करना चाहिए किस तरीके से, बिकॉज कुछ इसमें डायग्नोसिस या कुछ केसेस ऐसे होते हैं जिसमें कुछ मेडिकेशंस मिल रही होती है. सो वन हैज़ टू बी केयरफुल कि किस तरीके से, बट दे कैन कंसीव. क्योंकि मेरे हमारे पास भी स्टडी पार्टिसिपेंट बहुत सारे ऐसे थे जिनको पता ही उस वक्त चला जब उनकी दूसरी या थर्ड सेकेंड या थर्ड डिलीवरी थी या प्रेगनेंसी थी. सो दे कंसीव दे डिलीवर नॉर्मली, कोई इशू नहीं हुआ था. लेकिन अगेन हैविंग सेड दैट, इट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट कि जब शादी कर रहे हैं और जब फैमिली प्लान कर रहे हैं अपनी, तो बिल्कुल आप अपने कार्डियोलॉजिस्ट के साथ डिस्कस करें, गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट के साथ डिस्कस करें, एंड दे कैन डू एवरी थिंग. कोई ऐसी चीज़ नहीं है, बस ये कि कुछ केसेस के अंदर उनको मेडिकेशन लेनी पड़ती है टू सपोर्ट जिस भी किस्म के सिम्टम्स हो. क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ इम्प्रूव करने के लिए आई थिंक इट्स अ कलेक्टिव एफर्ट. फैमिली का रोल बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है, क्योंकि एक पर्सन जो है वो सबसे ज़्यादा टाइम अपनी फैमिली के साथ गुजारता है. फैमिली का रोल, और प्लस अगर वो पर्सन कहीं जॉब कर रहा है तो एम्प्लॉयमेंट, बिकॉज आप दो ही जगह सबसे ज़्यादा अपना टाइम स्पेंड कर रहे होते हैं, अपनी फैमिली के साथ और अपने जहाँ वर्क प्लेस है उसके साथ. या अगर कोई स्टूडेंट है तो वो जो भी एकेडमिक इंस्टीट्यूशन है, स्कूल है, कॉलेज है, यूनिवर्सिटी है. ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है कि जैसे बच्चा जब दूसरों बच्चों के साथ खेल रहा होता है, और कुछ केसेस के अंदर जैसे कि वो दूसरे बच्चों से, जैसे मैंने कहा फिजिकल एक्टिविटी, फिजिकल फंक्शनिंग में थोड़ा सा पीछे है, दैट्स परफेक्टली ऑल राइट. दैट बच्चा इज परफेक्टली नॉर्मल. ठीक है, तो वो ये पेरेंट्स के लिए भी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है समझना, और अपने बच्चे को एनकरेज करे. क्योंकि जो इमोशनली जब बच्चा जब देखता है कि एक बच्चा भाग रहा है ज्यादा और मैं उससे कम भाग रहा हूँ, स्लो हूँ, तो बच्चा इमोशनली भी जो है वो अफेक्ट होता है. तो ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है कि एज हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर्स, तो हमने जो पेरेंट्स को समझाना था या हमने जो पेशेंट से बात करनी थी, मगर फैमिली का रोल बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होता है. फैमिली जितनी ज़्यादा सपोर्टिव होगी, वो जो है उससे बच्चा जल्दी उससे जो है वो बाहर निकल के आएगा, और उसका कॉन्फिडेंस लेवल जो है ज़्यादा बढ़ेगा. इमोशनली जिस तरीके से वो जिस चीज़ से सफ़र कर रहा है वो कंपेरेटिवली बहुत बेहतर होगा. तो फैमिली का सपोर्ट, पेरेंटल सपोर्ट बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. और जैसे हमने कहा कि इसी तरीके से वी हैव टू बी रोल मॉडल्स. सो पेरेंट्स अगर स्ट्रांग रहेंगे, वो अपने फैमिली को उस तरीके से एजुकेट करें, एडवोकेसी करें, बिकॉज हर इंडिविजुअल जो हम में से सफर, चाहे वो CHD का पेशेंट है, चाहे हमारी फैमिली में कोई CHD है, चाहे वो पेरेंट्स हैं जिनके बच्चे कंजेनिटल हार्ट डिजीज से डायग्नोस पे हैं, या हम हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर्स हैं, या हम ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस का पार्ट है, हम सब एट आर इंडिविजुअल लेवल वी शुड बी एडवोकेट्स फॉर कंजेनिटल हार्ट डिजीज. अवेयरनेस फैलाने की बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरत है, और लोगों को उसकी अंडरस्टैंडिंग देने की बहुत ज़रूरत है कि किस तरीके से ये इंडिविजुअल दे आर ऑल्सो नॉर्मल. एम्प्लॉयमेंट वगैरह के लिए भी जो बहुत सारे एक मिसपरसेप्शंस है, और जो है सोसाइटी के जो डिफरेंट, जैसे मैंने कहा कि परसेप्शंस बड़े डिफरेंट है, उनका पर्सपेक्टिव बड़ा डिफरेंट है. आई थिंक इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड ये बिल्कुल नॉर्मल इंडिविजुअल्स हैं, और उनके साथ बाय बर्थ अगर किसी के साथ ही, तो किसी के साथ भी हो सकता है. सो विद दैट आई थिंक आई लुक फॉरवर्ड टू कि इंशाल्लाह collectively we'll work together to bring the change at individual level, at, you know, at different levels, so micro level, macro level, and you know, meso level. So collectively society ke level pe hum kya cheez impact dena chahte, this is very important.
Yeah, definitely I think the first step yahi hai ki jo aapne research wagaira conduct ki hai, evidence based practices jo hai wo hamare healthcare system mein implement karna, that is the first step. So thank you very much. We're ending this webinar on a very positive note. Aapka jo concluding message tha, it's very positive, and I hope a lot of girls, a lot of parents, a lot of children and their families who have been affected by congenital heart disease, they feel reinforced they feel empowered. You know, basically the whole concept of awareness is that the patient should feel empowered, and as health professionals I think hamara basic role bhi ye hona chahiye. So thank you very much Dr. Leela, it was a very nice discussion, very informative and very positive discussion. Thank you for joining us, thank you for being our expert speaker today, and thank you for everyone else, patients, families, health professionals jinhone hame aaj join kiya. And looking forward to future sessions with PCHF.
Thank you so much. Thanks for the invitation. I thoroughly enjoyed it.
Take care. Bye bye.
Take care. Bye. Allah Hafiz.